Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to My Hero Academia Season 2, Episode 24. This one's titled Katsuki Bakugo Origin. It's finally time for Team Midoriya and Bakugo's practical exam. What will they be able to do against All Might? Now, you'd think he's All Might, he's the number one hero. What can they do against him? We'll find out. I really should have done that spiel at the end of the last episode and be like, find out next time in Dragon Ball Z. Even though this is My Hero Academia, I would have still said Dragon Ball Z. But let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, now. Ooh, ominous wind. I still see the Moras hopping like Sue, but because he doesn't really run along jumping, he blast himself through the air, so I love it when an opening encompasses shows all the arcs that it's encompassing, and it's when it starts filling in your mind when you get up to the specific part it's referencing, and you'll be like, oh, that's what that's about. It's hard for most people to deal with him. It would be funny if the teachers mixed up the weights and someone like Aizawa accidentally got All Might's. I'll defeat you with air alone. Fucking rips up the ground. It has to be done every time. Yeah, stun grenade only works if it actually. Kachan could have easily just once he was around. And remember, a winner never loses. Of the old dirty as well. In Bakugo's eyes, a hero is someone who always wins. Always wins by incapacitating the villain. And with that comment right there, if I was All Might, I would have just fucking front kicked him. That's one way to have your teammate dodge the enemy's attack. Of course they're heavy. Combined, they'd be what, 112.5 pounds? Kilos, even? I forget if he was kilos or pounds. Kachan would have to be used to the recoil, have built up the muscles in the joints of his arm and shoulder to be able to withstand the. Whereas Midori wasn't expecting it. See, he doesn't jump around when he moves. He hasn't moved since they started running. He likes spicy food. He likes a tree. My, well, Mo Shindeu. Like fucking Hulk to Thor in the Avengers, just. Ow! That would have snapped his neck. I'll beat this motherfucker. I'll beat a motherfucker with another motherfucker. Okay, that looked like his hair was just slicked back, and that's not. No, the number one hero is the greatest hero? You did watch his sports festival fight, didn't you? Yep. Is fucking sprained all the muscles in. That's a snapped back. At least one bone was broken from that. Just watching that. It's most likely twisted, not actually broken, but is pulling a Deku. How would you feel if it had basically what could be described as a rocket coming out of your hair, focused entirely on the tendons and muscles in your forearm to hold it back, and just doing that constantly? That's how you do it. Yeah, to be fair, I would have done a dirty hit and gone straight for the wound. I would have definitely. So if hitting All Might without a strength enhancing quirk is basically like hitting a wall, would hitting him in the junk be the same? Just like, oh, I've broken my hand on your dick. Or would that only work if he wasn't flaccid? I'm asking the real questions here. Yeah, that back is definitely twisted. I haven't seen them in a while. And by a while, I mean a couple of episodes. We still don't know that guy's name. Well, I do, but. That right there, that is, I believe, what's referred to as a yandere. I think that's the term that they use. I've only ever experienced a tsundere character prior to this show. I know there's at least four types of dere characters. I just can't remember the other two. Well, at least he didn't get shut down this time. See, I'm tempted not to watch these previews because that's basically the entirety of the next episode. Just big reveal that he runs into Shigaraki. Yeah. I don't know what to say about that episode. Not in a bad way. No, that was a good episode, but I can't think of anything to comment on 'cause yeah. So we had Bakugo and Deku against their hero, and he did not hold back. As expected, Aizawa. But yeah, we see that Bakugo is not above injuring himself multiple times to win. We finally get it revealed as to what Bakugo sees a hero as someone who always wins in the end, who wins all the battles. He is the, well, not exactly physical, but anime representation of the. There's a saying that goes around where that choose your battles. I choose all of them. And yeah, that's basically Bakugo in a nutshell. Also, it's more clearly defined as to what his quirk weakness is. Which, there's still some that it's not, they don't exactly have a weakness. Like, so, the ones that we know, Izuku can't use his, power above a certain threshold or else he breaks his bones. Uraraka can't use her powers on more than a certain weight, otherwise she feels queasy. She's got on pressure point bands on to stop that, but as someone who used to get motion sickness, that those don't usually work to the extent you want them to. Tokoyami's is light, Kaminari's is, if he goes above a certain watt, no, yeah, wattage, then it fries his brain. Mina's hasn't been explained yet, but it's, she can still burn herself with her acid if it's too strong, and also she can burn through all her clothes, but yeah. Jiro, her sound can't go through, the ground, because sound doesn't travel through ground very well. Bakugo, his wrists are, yeah. You've got Sue, who, doesn't exactly have any weakness, as they said. You've got Momo, whose weakness was her confidence, or lack thereof. And now, she's still, her main weakness is the amount of fat she has in her body, limiting the amount of stuff she can make. But, yeah. Coda. Mr. Anavoice himself. He has not clear weakness, other than his fear of insects, which he faced. Yeah, most of them have weaknesses to their quirks, even the pros, but it's just whether or not we're shown it, or more how long it takes for it to be shown. There's also those whose weakness is that, well, they're not that bright. And yeah. But I think it would be the start of season 3 as to when we get a clear spelled out for us breakdown of the weakness of everyone's quirks. At least everyone in 1A. Because yeah. There are characters that I'm thinking of where I can't think of a weakness. But if you have someone with this immense power and no weakness because of it, that's not a compelling character. If you have someone who must figure out a way around their weakness to use their power, that interests people. And this show does that very well. But, with that being said, there's one episode left in this season, and I was sort of hoping to get it done before 6 in the morning, but yeah, I can't get a whole episode watched in 9 minutes. I'll catch you in the next one.